One of the most popular videos on my channel is about free SSL certificates. But does SSL still matter today? Yes, but can you still get away with free SSL? And are free SSL certificates really worth your time? To answer that question, we need to look at what SSL actually is. So what is an SSL certificate? Well, an SSL certificate is an encryption standard that provides that little lock icon in your browser. You know, when you go to a website and you see the URL and there's the little lock in the top left corner of your browser, or if you visit a website without an SSL certificate, it typically says not secure. And that's a big reason why you need an SSL certificate today. Nobody wants to browse a site that says not secure. And on top of that, the Google search algorithm favors websites that have an SSL certificate. So if you don't have an SSL certificate, your website looks sketchy and Google doesn't like it. It's gonna squish it down to a lower page. So with that in mind, should you pick a domain registrar, web host, or website builder with free or included SSL? Well, the answer is it depends. Now, it's certainly going to be more convenient to pick a registrar, web host, platform that includes SSL or has it for free. Why? Because everything's under the same roof. If you have a Wix website or a Squarespace website, they include SSL. You don't have to think about it. You just connect your domain name, build your website, boom, the lock icon is there. And it's a similar experience with web hosts like Dreamhost, Bluehost, Cloudways, or domain registrars like Porkbun include free SSL. It's convenient. You don't have to think about it. But what if you want to choose a web host that doesn't include free SSL? Should that be a deal breaker? Well, absolutely not, because there are other free ways to get SSL. I want to introduce you to Let's Encrypt. Now, Let's Encrypt is a nonprofit organization that issues free SSL certificates for everyone. But there are a couple catches to Let's Encrypt that you need to know about. Let's Encrypt by default issues 90-day SSL certificates, and it's not a very easy DIY process to carry out. Hosts like Cloudways, Dreamhost, and Bluehost work directly with Let's Encrypt to issue free certificates, and in the panels, it's always a breeze. You usually just click a couple buttons and it's automatically installed on your server. You do not have to think about it anymore. These web hosts also typically reissue the certificate for you automatically every 90 days. Again, making it so you don't have to think about it. But I would not recommend using Let's Encrypt directly to get an SSL certificate if your web host does not offer integration. It's not easy. If you want to use Let's Encrypt manually, you sometimes have to get into command lines and reissuing the certificate by hand every 90 days. It's not a very intuitive solution. And also watch out for web hosts that are giving you a free trial certificate. Hosts like Namecheap give you a free SSL certificate for the first year of hosting, then you have to pay to renew that certificate every year after. I've also seen GoDaddy do this and certain other web hosts. If you go to ssls.com, they'll tell you, hey, you can get a free SSL certificate with a 30-day free trial, so you get it free for a month and then you have to start paying for it. Be careful not to fall into that trap. If your web host does not offer forever free SSL or include SSL with what you pay for, you're going to want to go to the next solution, and that is Cloudflare. Now, Cloudflare is a free CDN and security firewall. CDN stands for Content Delivery Network. In other words, Cloudflare is caching a lot of your website files, like the logo and the CSS file, on hundreds of servers across the world. When the user visits your website, it's going to go to the nearest Cloudflare server to their geographic location and load the cached files. So maybe instead of the files traveling halfway around the world, they just travel a couple hundred miles. Cloudflare is also a security firewall. So they're constantly analyzing the traffic coming to your website, blocking hackers and bots, and Cloudflare also offers free SSL forever. And by the way, it's not using Let's Encrypt. Cloudflare is their own certificate authority, meaning they can issue their own SSL certificates, and they do this for free. Cloudflare is 100% free to use. It's really easy to set up. You basically just go to Cloudflare, enter your domain name, change your name servers to point to Cloudflare instead of your web host, and you're good to go. Now, within Cloudflare, you have two choices for free SSL: flexible SSL and full SSL. What does this mean? Flexible SSL encrypts the traffic from the Cloudflare servers to the browser. You're probably saying, Christian, what does this all mean? Well, with flexible SSL, you're going to get the lock icon in your browser. The Google algorithm is going to say, great, this is secure. Let's bump them in the rank. So flexible SSL is probably going to be fine for most people. Why is flexible SSL great? You don't have to think about it. If you set up Cloudflare, SSL is going to be working. Flexible SSL works by encrypting the traffic from Cloudflare to the user's browser. So the files are going from the web host to Cloudflare to the user's browser. So that second half, that bit from Cloudflare to the user's browser, is going to be encrypted. But you say, Christian, you just told me there was a missing link. What about the traffic from my web host to Cloudflare? Well, that would be using full SSL, which is also free. It just requires more setup. Because if you use full SSL, you need to install an SSL certificate on your web server. Some hosts may offer this for you, again, like Cloudways and DreamHost. You could use a free automatically issued Let's Encrypt certificate on your web host and then let Cloudflare do the rest for the rest of the way. Or Cloudflare actually offers to issue free SSL certificates for up to 15 years. So that way, although you do have to go through the pain of installing an SSL certificate on your web server, which can seem a little bit scary, you only have to do this once and you're good for 15 years. So unlike Let's Encrypt, you do not have to keep reissuing it every 90 days. And that's just if you know you need full SSL, which I would recommend if you're an e-commerce store or you have a login page. If you are taking sensitive information, it's really going to be best to go ahead and set up full SSL. But for everyone else, if you're a local business, you know, landscaping company or something like that, you could totally get away with flexible SSL, and that's automatically activated by just setting up Cloudflare and pointing your name servers to Cloudflare. So what really is the difference between free SSL like Let's Encrypt and paid SSL? Paid has to mean that it's better, right? Wrong. If you go to a site like SSLs.com, you're gonna see a range of certificates anywhere from $3.88 a year to over $120 a year. And you might be wondering, is one more secure than the other? Is one better? Does it have more features? And the answer is no. All SSL certificates are going to use the same encryption standards, offer the same benefits. They're all going to give you that lock icon that you're looking for and protect user data. So what are you really paying for when you fork over money for an SSL certificate? Well, it's usually two things. One, you're paying for a warranty. The SSL company is saying, hey, if this encryption ever gets broken, you'll get X amount of money. Typically, the more expensive the certificate is, the more the payout is. So a cheap paid certificate might be a $10,000 warranty. This is going to be your $3 or $4 a year certificate. And the expensive certificates might give you $250,000 of coverage or more. But to that, I would say, if you're a business that is that concerned about encryption being broken, wouldn't you have some pretty beefy liability protection? Do you really want to rely on some janky warranty policy on a paid SSL certificate as comfort that your business is going to be okay if that encryption got broken? Look, if you're a bank and you have your own online banking platform, you're not going to be relying on SSL certificate insurance to make sure your online bank doesn't get hacked. So honestly, I don't think it's worth paying for an SSL certificate for the warranty. There is one other thing you will sometimes get with paid SSL, and that's getting your business validated. Some of the high-end SSL certificates will require a manual verification process to make sure you are who you say you are. So sometimes they'll make you provide a DUNS number or some other form of verification to make sure, hey, this person applying for this SSL certificate is guaranteed to be this business owner. But what's the point of this? No user is gonna go in their browser and click the lock icon and look at the certificate details and go, ha, this was a premium SSL certificate? Oh, I guess that means that this business had to be validated before they got it issued, and clearly I trust them more. Nobody's gonna do that. People look at the lock icon. Does it have the lock? Yes. Oh, has lock? Good is secure. That's basically the extent of what users are looking for if they're deciding whether to trust a website. So how do I know if I need a free SSL certificate or a paid SSL certificate? Well, there are many different scenarios, but suppose you're a landing page. Should you use a free or paid certificate? I'd go with the free one. I don't see the point in paying for one. What if you're an e-commerce store? Go with the free SSL certificate. Okay, what if you're a business, a landscaping company, or a bakery? Go with the free SSL certificate. I think you see where this is going. I would never recommend paying for an SSL certificate with the free options that are out there. If you'd like to set up Cloudflare and free SSL on your WordPress website, definitely be sure to check out the tutorial I have. Link is up here. So in conclusion, should you be using free SSL on your website? Yes, I absolutely recommend free SSL for everybody if your host does not already include free SSL through Let's Encrypt or some other provider, use Cloudflare. I've been using Cloudflare on my websites for years to protect them and I've never had any problems. So what SSL solution do you use? I'd love to know your thoughts in the comments down below. And if you like this video, do be sure to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss when I release new videos. And by the way, I've just launched a brand new Discord community, so go join, link in the description below. We have all sorts of conversations over on Discord. And if you have any questions about using free SSL, go to the link in the description below, join the Discord server, it's free, type your question in the chat, and I will be happy to answer it. With that said, I'll catch you guys next time.